Good morning. Thank you very much for joining us here on Times Now. This is the newspaper show and I'm Hina Gambhir. Let's get started with the headlines that are there as far as the Times of India this morning is concerned. And the big story the Times of India today is leading with is what is happening between India and China after the Galwan face-off. India-China agree on gradual, verifiable disengagement. That's the top story here. Rajat Pandit has reported PLA intentions at Pangong So still a concern. Pullback first from Galwan. Gogra Hot Springs area. So that's the big update. An Indian fighter flies near Leh on Tuesday. That's the image that they have put. Disengagement will begin at face-off sites in Galwan Valley and Gogra Hot Springs, where rival troops are more or less on their own sides of the line of actual control. De-inducting additional battalions, artillery, guns, armored vehicles from depth or rear areas of confrontation sites set to follow. India to closely monitor the pullback through drones and surveillance aircraft. So that has now been agreed upon by both the countries. PLA general ordered Galwan assault. This is what a US Intel report has suggested. Then color codes are likely for Desi foreign products. This is what Siddhartha has reported. With an eye on Chinese products, the government is looking to mandate separate color codes for all domestic and foreign made goods on the lines of green and red dots for vegetarian and non-vegetarian items. Then Zomato evaluates if funding needs not. Zomato is the online food delivery app, which is yet to receive $100 million from the $150 million it raised from existing backer, China's firm, in January this year. And it is now evaluating if the capital will require government approval or not, because the government has been considering putting some sort of a restriction or at least a government nod in any sort of an investment coming from China to Indian companies. Then government gives China terse message at trilateral. India emphasize the importance of recognizing the legitimate interest of partners and oblique reference to China's actions against India during a special meeting at the RIC, which is Russia-India-China trilateral grouping on Tuesday. Apart from this, there is a lot happening between India and Pakistan as well. That's another story the Times of India this morning is leading with. India downgrades Pak ties, halves mission staff. Similar cut had happened last after 2001 attack that happened over the parliament. This is what Sachin Parasha has reported. Following Modi government's decision to reduce mission staff by 50%, India and Pakistan will cut their mission strength to 55 in 7 days. Mutually agreed strength until now was 110. The last time India asked for a similar reduction of staff was on 27 December 2001, 2 weeks after Jaish-e-Mohammed staged a terror attack on Parliament. As was the case in 2001, the government says in a statement that Pakistani mission officials in India maintained contacts with terrorist organizations. In fact, bilateral ties were already downgraded and with Pakistan having asked Indian High Commissioner Ajay Bisaria to return after India's decision to revoke J&K's special status. Sources say situation became untenable after ISI harassed and intimidated Indian mission officials in Pakistan recently. So that's about India and China, India and Pakistan. Then as far as China and Nepal is concerned, there is also an important update on the front page. China encroaching on our land. This is what Nepal government report has suggested. Now, something that is going to be a cause of concern for everyone, that's the fuel prices. For the first time, diesel has become costlier than petrol in the national capital. This after about 17 hikes that have happened in 17 days. That has been the impact. Then jobs returning, unemployment rate back at pre-lockdown levels. That's about the state of the economy. The unemployment rate fell to its pre-lockdown level of 8.5% in the week that ended on 21st of June, led by big gains in the rural areas, economic think tank Center Monitoring Indian Economy, CMIE, said. Then PM funds 3,000 crore for ventilators and migrants. The center on Tuesday announced the allocation of 3,000 crore from PM CARES Fund for supply of ventilators and supply of migrant laborers. Then apart from this, with one-day flights facing curbs, India considers travel bubbles. Pressure is now mounting on India to allow foreign airlines to operate scheduled passenger charters, as Air India is doing under the Vande Bharat mission. And US says Air India will require permission to operate flights to and from America from 22nd of July, and that Air India will need to apply 30 days in advance. So this can be an important factor as far as the Vande Bharat flights to US are concerned. Then hopes of 1.25 lakh shortlisted for Hajj have been dashed because here center has decided to not send people from India for Hajj pilgrimage because Saudi has also taken a big decision. New city cases spike hit almost 4,000 in one day, highest one day tally for any state, close to 4,000 cases reported in Delhi in just one day. India has recorded 1 lakh COVID cases in a week, new high of 15,600 that happened on Tuesday. 49% of parents surveyed want 2-hour e-classes. There is an update on the Rath Yatra that happened under curfew, and this is how it looked like yesterday in Puri. The usual sea of devotees and packed streets were missing, but still the procession went on. Then halt claims of corona cure. This is what government has told Patanjali, which has come out with the first cure for coronavirus. Regular trains not till August. This could be an important news. The Indian Railways will refund the full booking amount of all tickets booked up to 14th April for all regular timetable trains. This indicates Railway, which currently runs 230 special trains, won't resume the earlier regular passenger train services at least till mid-August. Then CRPF Jawan Jayesh Duo killed. Bail for Jamia student Safura. Two traders from Tamil Nadu have died in police custody. Lastly, tech sector in India. US hits out at Trump for suspension of H-1B visa. So that's about the front page of the Times of India this morning is concerned. Let's now move on and get you the latest as far as the Nav Bharat Times today morning is concerned. And here the first khabar hai, wo hai ki एलएसी के पीछे हटेंगी सेनाएं, भारत ने कहा रोड बनाते रहेंगे. तो जो इंडिया और चाइना के बीच में अग्रीमेंट हो रहा है उसके बारे में पहली खबर है, बड़ी जानकारी है. साथ ही पाक हाई कमीशन के कर्मचारियों को आधा करेगा भारत. भारत ने इशारों में चीन को सुनाया, ये भी एक बड़ी खबर है. यहाँ पर सरकारी पोर्टल पर बताना जरूरी है कि किस देश का सामान है, कंट्री ऑफ ओरिजिन को मेंशन करना बहुत जरूरी है. एक नया फीचर डाल दिया है गवर्नमेंट ने. पुरी में 2500 साल में पहली बार आम लोगों के बिना निकले भगवान जगन्नाथ, और ये तस्वीर है कल किस तरह से पूरी जगन्नाथ यात्रा निकाली गई थी. इस साल हज नहीं जा सकेंगे भारतीय, पूरा उन्हें रिफंड मिल जाएगा. साथ ही में रिकॉर्ड 3,947, 4,000 के करीब मरीज जो हैं आए हैं एक ही दिन में. नई दिल्ली में सिसोदिया ने एलजी से कहा कोविड सेंटर जाने का आदेश अपना वापस ले लें. केजरीवाल ने शाह को खत लिखकर मांगे सेना के डॉक्टर नर्स, और साथ ही शाह बोले यह तो 3 दिन पहले ही हमारे बीच तय हो चुका है. तो कहीं ना कहीं पॉलिटिक्स अभी भी चल रही है कोविड के ट्रीटमेंट को लेकर. देश में ठीक होने की रफ्तार बढ़ गई है, रिकवरी रेट दिन ब दिन बढ़ता चला जा रहा है, 56% से भी ज्यादा हो गया है. एलएनजेपी में 200 पर प्लाज्मा का ट्रायल होगा, इसकी अप्रूवल मिल गई है. भारतीयों को बड़ा झटका, इस साल H-1B वीजा नहीं है. और साथ ही कश्मीर में सीआरपीएफ जवान शहीद, और चुनाव से पहले आरजेडी में बगावत होती नजर आ रही है. सो दीज आर द हेडलाइंस एज पर द नव भारत टाइम्स दिस मॉर्निंग इज कंसर्न. लेट्स नाउ गेट यू द लेटेस्ट फ्रॉम द इकोनॉमिक टाइम्स, द पिंक पेपर. एंड टुडे वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग, सो देयर इज दिस मैगजीन इज वेल दैट यू विल गेट व्हिच हैज अ लॉट ऑफ इंटरेस्टिंग स्टोरीज and what you can really now do as unlock phase 2 is going to begin very soon. So it's an analysis of all of that. Then on the front page, green shoots of revival seen, government points to higher electricity and fuel consumption, increased goods movement, rising financial transactions. Finmin has listed 14 indicators which are suggesting some sort of economic recovery. That's something that the Economic Times today morning is leading with, and these are those sectors: automobiles, physical retails. So the demand recovery is seen, the good, the okay and the scary. This is the analysis the Times, the Economic Times has done. Credit card spends inch closer to pre-COVID levels. That's another survey that has been indicating a rise in credit card spends. Rural India brings down jobless rate to pre-COVID level. Shared mobility on a weak recovery path. Apart from this, checks on shipments to erect Great Wall against China. China goods, security fears amid border tensions, and industry fears move could delay import of key components. Government says there's no bar on any kind of a shipment. Then India-China agree to disengage. That's also another story that the Economic Times has on the front page. India to seek discussion on work visa suspension by US. Tech leaders say Trump move will impact recovery. And lastly, India may let US airlines operate Vande flights. So that can be important as well. Let's now move on and be more city-specific and get you the latest from the Delhi edition of the Times of India. My colleague Kangana is joining us on the broadcast this morning. Kangana, good morning. Today, the Times of India has firstly shown how the number of cases in Delhi have really gone up to over 66,600 right now. But the government has said that the daily new bed occupancy has come down.
Well, Hina, today's Times of India is filled with database stories because the central government had asked last week to the Delhi government to submit a proper data on the basis of COVID patients. So I'll be reading some data. Even though the cases are rising in the national capital, because yesterday night we saw the health bulletin where almost the cases in the national capital per day has touched 4,000. So after that also, they are saying that 56, as you just read in the previous headline, 56% is the recovery rate in the national capital, and apart from that, very few people with COVID-19 are being admitted in the hospital. So for example, in the first week of June, when they saw that 251 beds were only vacant, by the third week of June they have witnessed that 105 beds have been occupied. So this is the kind of rate that is showing that very few people are getting hospitalized in the beds. One more thing that they have said, that since the time they have started using the antigen test kit, that has also increased the number of samples that the Delhi government is taking every day. Close to 5,000 samples were being taken in the first week of June, and now the samples have gone threefold. The number have gone threefold, and that is also because the antigen kit is delivering results within 15 to 20 minutes. So that's the kind of database stories the Times of India's City Edition Delhi has covered today.
All right, Kangana, thank you very much for the moment for joining us with all of those details. In fact, there is something for those who want to go to Gurgaon, close to the national capital. Times of India is also reporting that coming to Gurgaon for 3 days, register online first. So this could be very, very important for the commuters, daily commuters. Specifically, NDMC office has been sealed for 48 hours because of the spike in cases. Another important story. Let's now move on and get you the latest from the Mumbai edition of the Times of India. My colleague Kajal Iyer is joining us on the broadcast. Kajal, good morning. 4 civic chiefs in MMR shunted out as cases rise.
Good morning, Hina. Yes, this is one of the top stories in all across all newspapers today, including the Times of India. And it talks of how there was a spike in the cases in Meera Bhayandar, in Thane, in Navi Mumbai, and Ulhasnagar. Together, these 4 corporations have actually seen a rise of 94% in cases since the unlock down began. And that's why the civic chiefs of all these places have been shunted out. None of them have even been given a new posting, and new people have been appointed there in the hopes that they could curb the rising number of coronavirus cases.
All right. Thank you very much, Kajal, for the moment, for joining us with all of those details. Another story in Thane, another transfer at top as cases grow fivefold in just 1 month. Maharashtra has reported highest 248 deaths in a day, 2 days after toll had hit 186. Another important update about COVID-19. Moving on now, and let's get you the latest from the Bengaluru edition of the Times of India this morning. Here, the big story is government caps COVID care in private hospitals at 10,000 to 25,000 per day. Imran, my colleague, is now joining us on the broadcast for more on this. Imran, good morning. Now, dearth of ambulances is hampering Bengaluru's virus fight.
Well, absolutely. The report clearly states that there has been only 7 ambulances, even though there has been a spike in number of cases in Bangalore. And then patients have been complaining that they have been having problems booking ambulances provided by the PBMP. And there are also reports of what the doctors suggest, that there could be a rise in number of cases because people are using the private vehicles or vehicles or public vehicles to come to the hospitals. And that is contributing to the rise in number of cases. Now, BBMP officials, however, deny that there is any, commissioner, that there is any deficiency in number of vehicles. Mayor blames it on the private hospitals for not providing their ambulances. Commissioner, however, says that adequate the report which has come out.
All right. Thank you very much, Imran, for the moment, for joining us with all of those details. We're now moving on to the Chennai edition of the Times of India this morning. And here the big story is that new Tamil Nadu cases have crossed 2,500. Again, tests are down by 6,000. That's one update. Apart from this, there will be no lockdown across the state, but strict curbs will happen in Madurai and Theni. That's the update. Is after Coimbatore, is this a cluster of 1,000 rupee dole? So there you can see, despite the intense lockdown enforced, family card holders stand in a line, flouting all social distancing norms Mylapore to receive the 1,000 rupee dole. So that's another story that has been highlighted here. A study has found that COVID curve may flatten by September end. Moving on, let's get you the latest from the Kolkata edition now of the Times of India. And here, of course, the big story is that how families are recalling how a happily ever after marriage went awry amid the chauvinism sowed seeds of discord. This is what the relative has said. Once seen as a very happy and successful couple among friends and relatives, Amit and Shilpi Agarwal's case is a classic example of love marriage turning sour that led to gruesome murders and suicide, where a city-based chartered accountant murdered his estranged wife at her Bengaluru home. So that's an update on that story. Tamal Saha, my colleague, is joining us on the broadcast. Tamal, good morning. No clearance of Chinese goods at City Airport?
Well, that's right. It's a very interesting development coming to light. And even though the Customs Department, they have not really confirmed this, but then the Cargo Association, they are suggesting that, about 40 tons of cargo worth 35 crores are now held up at the Kolkata International Airport and pending customs clearance. And the initial, and of course, the popular suspicion is after what really happened at the Galwan line of actual control, this decision has been taken by the central government to, in a way, hold up Chinese goods. Now, even though, as I said, the Customs Department, they have not issued any statement, but we are picking up that the dependence of the whole country on Chinese goods, it's huge. And in Kolkata, there are no less than 250 kinds of items are imported from China every month. Even during the phase of lockdown, PPEs were getting imported from China, and freight services were on. Freight services happened at Kolkata Airport carrying those PPEs and other medical equipments. So at this point in time, the growing concern is, if Chinese goods are not being allowed to come to the market, what would be a replacement of that, where the indigenous products would be able to suffice, and how soon can that happen?
All right. Thank you very much, Tamal, for the moment, for joining us with all of those details. There are some more important stories also that the Times of India this morning has reported, and we want to just quickly highlight those as well. 93-year-old beats COVID but kin reluctant to take her home. While authorities have declared her stable and medically fit for home quarantine, the family says the hospital must carry out another round of tests in a few days and guarantee that she's totally cured before they think about taking her back. In blow to Lalu ahead of polls, 5 of RJD's 8 MLCs have joined JDU. That's another big story here. CBI has summoned ex-chief minister amid political tussle in Manipur. BJP gets NPP mantris to Delhi for meeting. MP Pragya faints at BJP event, says she's losing eyesight because of Congress torture. And Agra DM has issued notice to Priyanka for sharing misleading COVID deaths tweet. Apart from this, UNICEF has said that school closure has affected 27 crore kids in India. And Another 100-year report has suggested that hills are heating up. The temperature has gone up in last 100 years as far as the hills in North India are concerned. India has one COVID death per lakh against world's six. That's another story that has been reported here. And no meeting with China's defense minister in Rajnath's plan as he is in Moscow. And let's get you the latest now from the world of sports. My colleague Karishma is joining us on the broadcast for more on this. MS Dhoni still has a lot to offer to Indian cricket. This is what Mohammed Kaif has said. Karishma, what else is making headlines today?
Well, Hina, good morning. The most unfortunate news that has been making headlines is Novak Djokovic, the world number one tennis player, testing positive for coronavirus along with his wife Yelena Djokovic. This is what has been making headlines since last night. Remember, Novak Djokovic has been coming under a lot of criticism for the ill-conceived Adria tour that he had organized, in which already three tennis players have tested positive. A pregnant wife of the tennis player has tested positive. Questions are being asked of Novak Djokovic as to why he was in a hurry to organize this particular event, especially when Novak Djokovic himself has in the past said that he is not ready to be vaccinated. He will not be forced to be tested, and he wants to take it slow and steady in his fight against COVID-19. So then what was the rush to organize this particular event in Belgrade, Serbia and Croatia? So, while everyone prays for Novak Djokovic and his wife's speedy recovery, criticism is going to continue against him as to why this particular tour was organized, which resulted in so many people, turning COVID-19 positive. There were after parties that were organized. Right. Why social distancing norms were not followed. All of this, Djokovic will have to answer, Hina.
All right. Thank you very much, Karishma, for the moment, for joining us with all of those details. A quick look at the news from around the world as well. U.S. industry tech companies slammed Trump move to curtail H-1B. America's laws, Pichai, Musk and other top honchos voice concern. Supercomputer fighting COVID is world's fastest. China and the U.S. are locked in a contest to develop the world's most powerful computer. Now a massive machine in Japan has stopped them both. A long-awaited supercomputer dubbed Fugaku, installed in the city of Kobe by the government-sponsored institute, took first place in a twice-yearly speed ranking released on Monday. Apart from this, EU may exclude US as it reopens borders. This is what a report has suggested. Sanofi eyes approval for vaccine early next year. A delivery man in Beijing may be a super spreader. That's another story that the Times of India has reported. News now from the world of entertainment, as far as the Delhi Times this morning is concerned. Saroj Khan has been hospitalized for breathing trouble. Saroj Khan was recently admitted to a Bandra hospital after complaining of breathing issues. A source close to her said a few days ago she was rushed to the hospital after complaining of breathing issues. Thankfully, it's not COVID. Then it's an update about how slowly the shootings have also started. TV shows were scheduled to resume shoots yesterday. The Federation of Western India Cine Employees and the Cine and TV Artists Association issued a circular on Monday stating otherwise. The circular stated no shoots can start till issues pertaining to sanitization, safety, payment schedule, insurance and shift timings are resolved. So that's about the latest on the Delhi Times page. With this, it's a wrap. Thank you very much for staying with us here on the Newspaper Show.